Just one day after Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker signed a bill slashing collective bargaining rights from union workers, nearly 100,000 protesters rocked the Capitol praising the return of the 14 Democrats who have been AWOL for nearly a month. All this while 17 Republican senators are getting death threats. So will Wisconsin lawmakers be able to work together going forward?
Wisconsin Governor Scott Walker joins us now. Governor, welcome.
Good to be with you.
Good to be with you. I'm glad you made some time for us. So first things first, now that this is done, in retrospect, did you ever anticipate this type of firestorm when you put these proposals forward?
I knew there would be a tension here in the state of Wisconsin, because anytime you take on the status quo, you got to be bold. And when you're bold, people who defend the status quo are going to get up in arms. But we had no idea the kind of national attention this would get, the kind of money that would come in from Washington and Illinois and Nevada and New Jersey and other places from these big union bosses who didn't want us to change things. But the irony is we're protecting middle class jobs and middle class property taxpayers. And we're going to continue to do it for the people of Wisconsin.
Well, I saw an item that said that there were a number of Republican senators who said that they had heard from their constituents, despite these gigantic protests over the weekend, like, hey, you're doing the right thing. Go ahead. Keep going with this. We got to make some changes.
Well, there's no doubt about it. As people understand the facts are clear, we are doing something that's no more bold than what the federal government does. Mm-hmm. Many people don't realize, maybe even the president doesn't realize, that federal government employees do not have collective bargaining for wages and benefits. Other states have done this most recently. A few years back, Indiana did this under Governor Mitch Daniels, and they have a government now that's more efficient, more effective, more accountable to the public. In fact, the great thing is not only do we save money to balance our budget without having to lay people off in mass numbers and without massive tax increases, we can actually improve our schools. We can now put the best and the brightest in based on performance, not based on seniority.
You know, the biggest rap with this whole push to eliminate collective bargaining rights with public unions was that, well, the governor's not doing this to balance the budget. He's doing this for political purposes because everybody knows the unions support Democrats. But when the Senate President Scott Fitzgerald came out and said that the result of this decision was going to affect the outcome of the presidential race when it comes to unions, didn't that hurt their cause and fuel your enemy?
Well, I think the reason that the Obama administration, the president himself, got involved is because they believe that. The people who politicized this are the 14 state senators who left the state of Wisconsin and went to another state. I mean, think about it. Any middle-class worker who was gone from their job for 3 weeks without notice wouldn't be working anymore. Yep. And yet that's exactly what they've done. They're the ones who politicized this. Thankfully, they've come home. I think they're some of the reasonable ones we tried to work with over the last couple weeks to bring back. Are the same people who helped us the first 5 weeks. You asked at the beginning, will we be able to work together? Absolutely. For the first 5 weeks, we passed some of the most aggressive pro-jobs pieces of legislation in the entire country to show that Wisconsin was open for business. That included both Democrat and Republican votes. I'm sure we can get back to that as well.
Sure. Well, of course, there are reports that apparently a number of Republican senators have received death threats. And have you seen Time Magazine? They've got a headline, Wisconsin's governor wins, but is he still dead man Walker? And then inside in the first paragraph, it describes a chalk outline. I thought after Tucson, that kind of stuff was over the line.
Well, if you looked at the signs around the Capitol, particularly those that came in from other states outside of Wisconsin, you'd see it was tenfold worse than what we saw there in terms of the comments by opponents. But we've stayed focused. I've said, you know, the protesters, at least those from Wisconsin, have every right to be heard, but they're not going to overpower the voices of the literally millions of taxpayers in this state who want us to balance the budget, who want us to protect middle-class jobs, and who want us to get the job done that we said we're going to do down. And we're not going to be intimidated. In the end, we're going to do what's right for Wisconsin.
All right. Scott Walker, the governor of Wisconsin, we thank you, sir, for joining us today from Madison.
Hey, good to be with you guys. And one quick thing, just we've got a lot of friends in Japan. Our prayers continue with them. We're going to continue to reach out to groups like redcross.org to make sure we help in Wisconsin, help those in Japan.